Hi readers, I'm Terry, and this is my review of The House on Paradise Street by Sofka Zinoviev. I think I said that right. Anyway, this is going to be a difficult review. There are so many things going on in this book. Let me tell you what this book covers thematically first. This is a story of two sisters and two different ideologies. This is a story of war between both nations and family members. And as the author says, war that forces politics right into the heart of the individual and the family. I really, really like the way she put that. If I had to use one phrase that sums up this book, the themes in this book, that would probably be it. It's about what happens when ideology takes over our humanity. This is a story about the way that perceptions and experiences shape us and our lives, the way that our past shapes our present. The decisions we make in the past definitely shape our present. It's about both exile and the experience of a foreigner in a new land. It's about nationalism and the way that a nation and people see themselves versus the way that outsiders see them. This is a story about political meddling from abroad, and the impact, most specifically, the impact of World War II and the Greek Civil War on the Greek people. Those are the themes. There's a lot going on there. This story is told from the point of view of two women. One, Antigone, she is an older woman who lives in exile in Russia, has since after World War II. The other point of view is Maud. She is a middle-aged woman. She is an English woman who married Antigone's son and has been living in Greece for quite a few years. So she brings the perspective of an outsider who has been trying to live within a Greek family, and all the struggles that go with that, whether it's language struggles, various cultural struggles, some of them were very personal. Maud was married to Antigone's son. Antigone, when she went into exile, her son was three. She has not seen her son or had anything to do with her son since that time. Maud is newly widowed. This son, his name is Nikitas, he has died, and we're not really given an explanation for that until closer to the end of the book. What happened? Was it a suicide? Was it an accident? Something was going on with Nikitas, and it all ties into this whole idea of the personal fallout from what happened to this nation. I knew nothing really about Greece and about their civil war, about what happened to them after, you know, World War II, other than, you know, lumping it in with what happened to everybody after World War II, especially the smaller countries. I'm aware of things like, you know, the powerful, excuse me, playing games with, I guess you could say that, political games, you know, carving up the Middle East, you know, and saying, okay, well, you know, we'll back off over here if we give, you know, if you back off over there. And then the local people, the citizens of those countries, having to live with that. It just causes horrible disruption. I can't tell you a whole lot about, it's not really so much a plot-driven book as it is about the characters and about the themes that I mentioned. So there's not a lot to tell you about plot, and I don't want to go into too many specifics and ruin it for you if you're going to read it. It was a slower read. It wasn't a difficult read. It was just something that was better served by reading it at a slower pace. Two points of view and a little bit of going back and forth in time from, you know, past to present didn't really bother me over much. I have mentioned before in other places that this kind of, you know, point of view shift, time shift can be a little bit disconcerting to me. This didn't really, it wasn't troublesome. I was pretty clear on who was talking and where we were in time at most points in time. The writing. I thought the writing was solid. It wasn't particularly lyrical, but I thought it was very solid. I thought that the author told the story, told it well, stayed on point. This would be very difficult. This author has written nonfiction, a lot of nonfiction. And, well, I don't know if a lot is correct, but she's written nonfiction. So she's gone into the fiction realm. This would be, you know, maybe difficult to address these themes. And at no point did I feel like this author was trying to push one side over the other. Basically what we're talking about is the left as in communism and the right as in fascism. To really say over much about, you know, one being, you know, better than another, it was more about the devastation that's caused by these kinds of, you know, ideologies and, you know, people, families, nations are destroyed by fights over these things. So she was mostly just showing that, and I felt empathy for most characters. I could understand where they were coming from for the most part. So, you know, in that, I think she was very, very successful. I'm very curious if others have read this, what they, you know, what do you think? If you've read this, what do you think about the way the author handled this? I think that's an important conversation for this particular book. So this book, I would very much recommend to people who like to learn about history through fiction, and to people who maybe specifically want to know about Greek history, especially, you know, after World War II and what happened in that area of the world because of World War II. If you're looking for something really fast, plot-driven, this wouldn't be the book for you. But I think it was well-written. I think that most people who read what many of us would consider literary fiction, I think most people who like that type of fiction or who are very interested in history and the results of history on present-day affairs, I think these people would like this book. Those are my thoughts. As scattered as they are, I was trying to be fairly succinct here. It's a difficult book to really talk about. If this sounded interesting to you at all, I would recommend The House on Paradise Street. Definitely worth a read. If you have read it, let me know in the comments what you thought. Thanks for watching.